Hey there guys, it's me Greg, and today I want to talk about first and latest expansion to Tapestry, Plans and Ploys. It's called expansion, but what do we can find inside? It's I think more like an add-on, more like an upgrade of the Tapestry. It's hard for me to say about this very small box that it's some kind of very big expansion. And because of that, I don't want to also score this product and give scratches or whatever, because I think that's not the point in the case of this product. So I will just show you what we can find inside and what kind of new mechanics, what kind of new stuff we can find inside. I love Tapestry. I think that Plans and Ploys, it's a must for everyone who loves this game. So let's dig in and let's check out what every Tapestry fan can find inside this box. All right, Tapestry Plans and Ploys. As you can see, this box is much smaller than the core box of the game. It's like this. So it's very, very small box. And inside, we don't get a lot of components, but I think they are very cool. So let's check out what we have inside. So first of all, we have those two leaflets. First one is for Automa. It's they all introduces few new rules, and the most important thing for solo players that we have that, let's say, campaign or something like this, built with five scenarios, so you can go through those five scenarios, and I think you can treat it as a campaign. So and the second one, it's a leaflet of the new things in this box. It's not much, it's just a leaflet. So that's it. Now first thing I want to show you, oh, it already doesn't fit in the box. It's a bag, it's a linen bag. I already have my tiles inside it, so that's why it doesn't fit. But I love it, it's so cool. I never seen the linen bag in any of the games. So it's very, very cool add-on to store your the tiles that you have to draw randomly. So now we are opening the lid, and we have, first of all, 10 new civilizations. We are going to them soon. First of all, new tiles of the cosmos, let's say. Four are new. One is that extra to replace with a misprint. I had base game with the misprint, so I'm using this one. The previous one is already in the trash. And four new tiles, that this one allows you to build a monolith in your city. And three extra tiles that give you victory points accordingly to the progress on your tracks. Next thing, very cool one, I love it. These are goals that you can follow during your game or building your strategy. So you, every player will get one of these cards. For example, game store, it's a landmark, and you can gain that landmark at the end. If you, at the end of your turn, you will have at least one technology in your top row, gain this landmark. So landmark takes this amount of space in your city and you can build it. Another one, urban farm. At the end of your turn, if you have at least six tiles in your supply, gain this landmark, and it's also almost one full district. So thanks to those cards, skyscraper, digital studio, and TV station. So thanks to those cards, it's easier to plan your strategy because you have a goal from the beginning of the game to get those tiles, or to have technology or whatever. So those are, that's a very cool add-on. Next one, very cosmetics, like silly thing. Those tokens that you are putting on a board during the setup, on the places, that showing that if you are the first player who enters that place, gains that type of landmark. So for example, it's easier to just follow and navigate which of the landmarks are still available and which ones are already taken. So it's easier to play, it's easier to follow, but it's like silly extra thing. And of course, miniatures, they are similar to the things that we know from the core game. And I think that's my biggest issue with this expansion, because I expected that those landmarks that we can build will be much more diverse, new and fresh.
Those buildings, most of them, I have an impression that they look exactly like things that we can find in a core game. Only one new shape is this one. It's a stadium, I guess, like old stadium. And that's the only building that is just different and looks different on your board. And the monolith that you can build thanks to that space tile. And what else? Now civilizations. So we have 10 of them, and civilizations introduces a little bit of negative interaction. Not all of them, but few of them. First of all, river folk. For I will show you not all of them because it's 10 and I didn't play all of them, so I can tell you more or less the things I knew and I experienced by myself. So river folk, they gain extra victory points at the beginning of the game for every two unpassable plots in every district. And your goal is to cover those impossible plots, because on your final income turn you will lose one victory point per visible impossible plot, and you also gain extra resources for covering all impossible plots in one district. So that's river folk. Next one is aliens. They are very powerful because they start with space tiles and they can explore them during their turn, and you don't have to, you know, be at the end of the track where you can get those tiles. Spies are specific. That's a civilization with a little bit of negative interaction, because thanks to the spies you can copy bonuses from your opponents. So here you have 4 bonuses, and if you put your markers in these places you can get those extra things that are written over here. Next, thinkers, I don't know them. Islanders, so they are living on an island, and you will be building that island around during your gameplay, and you will gain extra points for that. And this one I didn't play with them. Recyclers, so they can recycle technology cards when they have their, for example, if they have them on over here, they can put the civilization back on the lowest track and again discover it. So they can use those cards few times, and that's completely new mechanic, completely new thing, as those cards when they are on the top row they're done. Yeah, infiltrators, and didn't play with them. And advisors, they are very specific, and I think if you like to mess with strategy of your opponents, or that civilization can be for you, because advisors can, let's check this out, during advancement turn, not income turns, whenever a neighbor would gain a tapestry card, instead of them drawing it from a deck, I think it's a typo, from a deck, you may give them a card of your choice from your hand. If you do, after you give them a card, gain a tapestry card. So you can force your opponents to take like very very weak tapestry card in your hand, or tapestry card that is useless for them in this specific moment of the game. So advisors are very cool, and if you like to mess, as I said, if you want like to mess with your friends, with your opponents, that civilization is for you. And oh yeah, and finally of course we have those 4 cards for automa with new rules and a lot of new tapestry cards. So this one where you can get that landmark with stadium, also what else, manifest, destiny, public works, world's fair, astronomy, that's very cool because you can get gain also extra space tiles, very useful, double cross, cartography, status quo, engineering, surprise party, retreat, surrender, stolen plans, infrastructure boost, architecture, and that's it. So that's a very small expansion, but it gives just cool oomph to the game, and that's it. So don't expect a lot from this expansion, but I think that author created this just to address all those negative voices that we could read in the net, for example, about Tapestry when the game was released, that this one specifically. And those voices were also heard in our home when our friends played with us. They said that Tapestry is super confusing. They don't know what to do. There are four tracks and they don't know how to navigate on those tracks. And thanks to those landmarks from goals, I think that would be much easier for them to now understand and build a strategy of their own. So that's it. That's the plans and ploys. I think that's a must add-on for every Tapestry fan, and we are waiting for something bigger with new mechanics and not just cosmetic add-ons. So thank you so much for watching and see you in the next game.